जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू फिजिक्स क्लास ऑफ ग्रेड 11। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिलेटेड टू द वेक्टर्स। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज मल्टीप्लिकेशन ऑफ अ वेक्टर बाय अ स्केलर। इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल टॉपिक। व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट लेट आई एम हैविंग अ वेक्टर ए, ए इज 5 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर in the east. Now I will multiply this A with scalar. So first case is with positive number. Let us say 5A. What will happen in that? 5 multiplied by the value of A, that is 5 meter per second square is, so what is the value? 25 meter per second square is. So what does it mean? It means that if I multiply a vector with a positive number, then its magnitude also get multiplied with that number and the direction remain the same. If I say let me multiply 1 by 2 with A, then what it will be? 1 by 2 multiplied by the 5 meter per second square is, what can I say? I can say that it is 2.5 meter per second square is. Second is, if I multiply with negative number, let us say multiply with the negative number. If I multiply with the negative number, what will happen in this case? The positive number that I explained you, the negative number, let us say again minus 5A. What will happen? Minus 5. What is A? 5 meter per second square east. So what can I say? Minus 25 meter per second square east. Now, what is the opposite of east? It is the west. So I can also write it as 25 meter per second square west. So what does it mean? It means that if a vector is multiplied with the negative number, then its magnitude also get multiplied, but the direction is reversed, that is direction becomes opposite of the given direction, and the opposite of the east is west. Number 3, with another physical quantity, physical quantity having units. Remember, physical quantity is scalar having units. For example, if A here is 5 meter per second square, and if I multiply with the mass of 10 kilogram, what will happen? It is again east. MA, what it will be? 10 kilogram. And what is A? 5 meter per second square east. What can I say? I can say 50 kilogram meter per second square. And all of us know that kilogram meter per second square is unit of force. So I can write it as the 50 newton. So what can we say? We can say that if a vector is multiplied with a physical quantity having units, then it may result it into other physical quantity. Here we have taken acceleration, and what the result? Result is the force. So when we multiply a scalar physical quantity having units with other physical quantity, then definitely result in different physical quantity having the different unit. For example, I multiplied mass with acceleration. What I got? I got the force. So this is the same multiplication of a vector by a scalar. Second is addition of vector or composition of vectors. Addition of vectors. Number two, addition or composition of vectors. What is the addition or composition of the vector? Addition or composition of vector means it is the process of adding two or more vectors. So the process of adding two or more vectors is called composition or addition of vectors. What I said? Let us say I am having the vectors A and B. When I add A and B, this process is called vector addition of A and B or the composition of A and B. Now question is, what will be the result called? Definitely when I am adding two vectors, definitely it will have some result, and this result is called the resultant. So what is the resultant is obtained when two or more vectors are added. How can I define? It's very easy. Resultant of two or more vectors is a single vector which produces the same effect as is produced by individual vectors together. Let us say I am having a vehicle. My target is to push the vehicle. Let us say there are two people who are pushing this vehicle. One is pushing with the force of 100 Newton. Another is pushing with the force of 500 Newton. So what is the total force here? The total force here is 600 Newton. Then this 600 Newton is called the resultant of 100 Newton and 500 Newton. So what is the resultant? Resultant is a single vector. This is a single vector which produces the same result as is produced by individual vectors together. If these vectors are together, what effect they produce? The same effect can be produced by single vector together. If I say 100 and 500 Newton can move this vehicle, and if 600 Newton force is also applied, then this single 600 Newton force can move the vehicle. So this 600 Newton is the resultant of 100 Newton and 500 Newton. So what is the resultant? Resultant of two or more vectors is a single vector which produces the same result as is produced by individual vectors together. Note, there is a very important note that vector A plus B equals to B plus A. What does it call? It means that vector addition is commutative. Commutative. What does it mean? You have done 3 plus 4 is 7. Then 4 plus 3 is also 7. What does it mean? If I add vector B in A, I will get the same result as adding vector A in B. Just like 3 plus 4 is 7, 4 plus 3 is also 7. So what does it mean? It means that vector addition follows the commutative law. Second point is A plus B plus C, it equals to A plus B plus C. What does it mean? It means that vector addition follows the associative. For example, 3 plus 8 plus 4. If I put 8 and 4 in brackets, I can also write 3 plus 8 in brackets plus 4. So what this is? This is associative law. So vectors, they follow commutative law of addition and associative law of addition. Next is laws of vector addition. How we can add two vectors The first method is geometrical method. What this method is? Geometrical method. How we can add two method by using this geometrical method? Let us say we are having two vectors in same directions. Let us say we are having two vectors, they are in same direction. Let us say I am having vector A. This A is 5 meter per second square, direction is east, and this is vector B and it is 2 meter per second square. Both are having the same direction. Now what is the rule of addition of vector? This rule says that first of all, put the tail of vector B on the head of vector A. This is the head of vector A. On this head I am going to put the tail of vector B. So, what this complete vector? This complete vector is the resultant. So, this complete vector, it is the resultant, that is A plus B. So, when two vectors are in same direction. Now, second is, when two vectors are in opposite direction, what will happen in that case? Let us say again I'm having vector A. It is 5 meter per second square and I'm having vector B. It is 2 meter per second square. But my target is to add A and B. What I will do? This is the vector A. What I will do? I will place tail of vector B on the head of vector A. This is the head of vector A. Over this, I am going to put the tail of vector B. Where I have put the tail of vector B? Then this is the vector B. Then vector from the tail of A to the head of B, this vector, it gives the resultant, that is this vector, it gives vector A plus B. So what will happen in this case? In this case answer will be 3 meter per second square. Complete is 5, here 2, so answer is 3 meter per second, because their directions are opposite. In this case, their direction was same. So this complete vector, it is a plus b, and here in this case, it is a plus b. Next is, if vectors make some angle with each other, in case of angle between 0 and 180 degree, angle between 0 and 180 degree, what will happen in that case? Now first of all, what is the angle between the two vectors? Let us say I am having vector A, I am having vector B. Then angle between two vectors is the angle between the directions of A and B. A is there, B is there. So this theta is the angle between the A and B. If I say my one vector is this and another vector is this, so what is the angle between A and B? I will not say this is the angle between A and B, because the direction of A is this. So I will say this is the angle between A and B. So whenever I am saying angle between two vectors, what does it mean? It means that angle between the directions of the two vectors. So let us say, if we are having two vectors, let us say vector is this, another vector is this. I have to find the resultant of vector A and B. Now these vectors, they are neither in same direction nor in opposite direction. So what we will do? We will draw a vector A and we will do the same thing that we have done. We will place the tail of vector B over the head of vector A. This is the tail of vector B over the head of vector A. Then the vector from the tail of vector B to the head of vector A, it gives the addition of two vectors. So this is the geometrical method, right? And if I am having a number of vectors, let us say this is the, say I am having three vectors A, B, C, how to find its resultant? Same thing. What I will do? I will take vector A, and on the arrowhead of vector A, I will place the tail of vector B. Let us say this is the vector B. Tail of vector B is placed on the arrowhead of vector A. Vector C, I will again place the tail of vector C over the arrowhead of vector B. So this is vector C. Now, the vector starting from the tail of vector A to the arrowhead of vector C, it gives the resultant of ABC, that is the sum of ABC. Then this vector is vector A plus vector B plus C. So what this is the same? This is the addition of vectors by geometrical method. Now there are some analytic method also. Next is triangle law of vector addition. What is the triangle law of vector addition? How can we explain the triangle law of vector addition? Let us take triangle law. What does it mean? We will find the addition of two vectors by using a triangle. Now, what is the triangle law of vector addition? Let us say we are given any two vectors, let us say this is vector A and this is vector B. My target is to find the resultant of vector A and B. I will do the same thing. First of all, what I will do? I will make these vectors in the same order. What is the meaning of the same order? Same order means, as we have done earlier, that if I place the tail of one vector on the arrowhead of other vector, then what I will say? I will say that these vectors are in same vector. Then a third vector which encloses the triangle but in opposite order, it will give the resultant of, will give A plus B, because A and B are in same order. Now let me explain once again. Here we are having vector A, here we are having vector B. The tail of vector B is falling on the arrowhead of A. So I will say A and B are in same order, but the arrowhead of R and arrowhead of B, they are facing each other. So I will say R and B, they are in opposite order. Now look at this. In this triangle, arrowhead of A and tail of B, they are falling on each other. So A and B are in same order. Similarly, tail of C is falling on the arrowhead of B. So I am saying that C and B are in same order. And arrowhead of C is falling on the tail of A. So I am saying that C and A, they are in same order. Now question is that, what is the value of resultant? How we can find the resultant? What is the value of the resultant? Now, triangles law of vector addition. Now, let us say we are given two vectors. One is vector A, another one is vector B. We are given two vectors. One is vector A, another is vector B. I have to find the resultant of A and B. How I will find? I will draw a vector which starts from the tail of A and ends on the arrowhead of B. This is the resultant. So what I am saying that, what was the triangle law of vector addition? If two vectors A and B represented in magnitude and direction by two sides of the triangle taken in same order, then the resultant in magnitude and direction will be given by the third side of the triangle taken in opposite order. I am repeating the definition once again. If two vectors are represented by two sides of the triangle taken in same order, then their resultant will be represented by the third side of the triangle taken in opposite order. Remember, these sides, they represent the vector in magnitude as well as in direction. Now, if I ask what is the angle between A and B, can you tell that angle? Okay, the angle between A and B, let us say this angle is theta. Why this angle is theta? The reason is this: direction of A is B and direction of A is this, direction of B is this, and the angle between A and B is theta. Now from here, I will draw a perpendicular on vector A produced. So let me write the names O, P, So what I did? I draw a perpendicular S, draw SQ perpendicular OP produced. Now it is very much clear that OP vector equals to vector A, OS vector equals to R, and PS vector it equals to vector B. What does the triangle law of vector says that third side OS equals to OP plus PS, that is R equals to vector A plus vector B. Now, my target is to calculate the R in terms of A, B and theta. Is there any law in the triangle by which I can calculate the third side? In this triangle, no. So what I have to do? I have to make a right angle triangle, and I know the Pythagoras theorem. So using triangle, that right triangle OQS. What is in this? OS square equals to OQ square plus QS square. What is OS? It is R square. OQ, it equals to OP plus PQ. And what is QS? QS I have to calculate. This is equation 1. So I want PQ. What is PQ? Now, in triangle, right triangle PQS, PQ is the base and this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse. So, base upon hypotenuse equals to cos theta, therefore PQ equals to PS cos theta, right? And what is PS here? PS is B. I can write it as B cos theta. Similarly, QS is the perpendicular upon hypotenuse is sin theta, therefore QS equals to PS sin theta. What is PS? PS is again B, B sin theta. Now put in 1, therefore R square equals to OP. OP is A, because OP is A. And what is PQ? B cos theta. Plus QS square, what is QS? B sin theta. Now open this bracket, what we will get? A square plus B square cos square theta plus 2AB sin theta plus B square sin square theta. So what? A square. Now here we are having a term, B square cos square theta plus B square sin square theta. So I can say plus B square common cos square theta plus sin square theta plus 2AB cos theta. And what is cos square theta plus sin square theta? It equals to 1. So I can say R square equals to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. right? Now, so what the R will be? R will be under root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Now question is, what is the angle between the resultant and vector A? Let us say beta is the angle between the resultant and A. Let beta is the angle between R and vector A. So what can I write? Tangent beta. In which triangle? In triangle OQS. What is tangent theta? Perpendicular upon base. SQ divided by OQ. What is SQ? SQ, it equals to, this is QS, that is SQ, it equals to B sine theta. B sine theta. And what is OQ? OQ, OQ, it equals to OP plus PQ. OP plus PQ. And what is OP? OP equals to B. OP equals to A. This is OP, it equals to A. And what is PQ? B cos theta plus B cos theta. So I can say tangent beta equals to B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. So this is the expression of triangle law of vector addition, and this triangle law of vector addition is very very important for 11th as well as for 12th. Thank you and have a nice day.